So I am talking to you from Colorado. I live in a suburb, Lakewood, and just to the west of Denver. I've been here for quite a few years, 20 years. I'm 71 years old. I'm a biologist, or was a biologist, or studied to be a biologist. I have kept up with a lot of the literature on cannabis because it's we have recreational cannabis here in Colorado, as well as medicinal cannabis, and we also have CBD, which is the latest, and a lot of people are using CBD here in the Denver area. There are stores on street corners and strip malls, etc., where I can buy CBD. I buy the CBD oil, which is different than a hemp oil or any of the other types of CBD. It's in a small bottle with a dropper bottle, and it's CBD. I think they dissolve it in coconut oil. You can get it in several different stores here in my neighborhood. But it's definitely, I need to make it clear that that's CBD oil, not hemp oil. And the strength that I get in those bottles, I buy five grams dissolved in 30 milliliters. So let's see if I can tell this, if I can get this. Yeah, small bottle, about that big. And it's 30 milliliters. And they give you, like I say, I buy the 5 gram bottle. It's 5,000 milligrams, 5,000 milligrams of CBD, which is 5 grams of CBD in that bottle. And I've been using 500 milligrams per dose. So it's about 3 or 4 squirts from this this little bottle, dropper bottle. And so 500 milligrams a day. I'm taking care of a lady who is 84. She's older than me. She has cancer, and I've been taking care of her for about 5 months now. I started using CBD for her probably 2 months ago, and we worked up to the point where she is taking 500 milligrams of CBD per day, and she mixes that in with a drink that she drinks at lunch. You can mix it in with water. I think she puts in a shot of vodka, and it just makes it taste better, although there isn't much of a taste to CBD. It's in coconut oil, and you don't really taste it, although I can get, and I told her that I could get flavored CBD. There are some stores that offer that. So she has breast cancer. She was diagnosed. She says she had a lump in her breast from the beginning of 2019, January, or right around Christmas or whatever, she first noticed the tumor. She decided she didn't want to be treated. She went for until November of 2019 without really talking about it to anybody. But she took a fall in her house and ended up in the hospital. Doctors found the lump and did an assay. They put her through, like, I think a PET scan or whatever, and found that yes, she did have breast cancer, and it had metastasized to her lungs, to her liver, and to the bones. And that's where she was when I started caring for her through a tragedy. Ended up being her caregiver, and after a month or 6 weeks or whatever, she started to heal up from the fall that she took, and it was a bad fall. She fell on her face and banged up her face, and she had a big lump on her head. So it took a while for her to recover, but once we got her going, got her up out of the bed and starting to walk and stuff again, she started doing better. And she didn't want any treatment at all for the cancer. So I suggested that we could try CBD, because in the past, in the literature, and I'm, like I said, a biologist, and I followed it, there was a person up in Canada, Simpson, and he did experimenting with high doses of THC to cure cancer. And he said at one point that if a person took 60 grams of THC in a 90-day period of time, that it would cure any cancer that a person would have. So that's what I had to go on. Not a whole lot, but I said, well, let's try CBD. It's different than THC, but I said, you'd never be able to handle. That's one of the reasons that that nobody ever really followed up on it with the THCs. It gets you so high that people can't take that. It's, you know, blows you right off the roof, I would imagine, taking that much THC. However, CBD has become very popular here in Denver and everywhere, I think. And so we have CBD, which does not get you high, and it's not illegal. It's made from, I think, industrial hemp, and they may make it from the regular cannabis. I can't tell. I don't know, but I know that CBD can be sold to anybody, and it has less than 0.3% THC in it, and so it's legal. It doesn't have any effect on your brain or whatever. So I said, we'll try this CBD, and she was in pain, and she's getting old, and I said, it should help with pain, the CBD, and we'll give it a try and see if I can't get it up to a high enough dosage where it has an effect on your cancer. I know also from literature that cannabinoids, THC and CBD, can kill cancer cells. I think the process is apoptosis, which is really programmed cell death, there are other molecules, I think, that can trigger that as well. But anyway, CBD and THC, I believe, can do that for sure. So I said, well, we'll give it a shot. So I started her off with a small dose just to see if it did anything to her, some gummy bears and things, just to see if they had any effect. And no, the smaller amounts of CBD didn't do anything. I worked her up a week at a time. I got a bottle of CBD. It took about a week. It was a 1 gram bottle. Then I went to a 2.5 gram bottle. And then I went right up to a 5 gram bottle, giving her enough to, it's about 400 or 500 milligrams per day. And we've been staying with that amount for quite a while now. And I think that, as far as I can tell in my conversations with her, that the tumors that she have in her breast, and she has one tumor underneath her arm, probably in the lymph nodes, she said they're not, I don't think they're growing anymore. And she thought that she had lesions as well that were bleeding, and those have healed up. And I think we're putting stopping the growth of those tumors, if not killing them. And they won't disappear right away, because they would have to be reabsorbed by the body, and that's not going to happen for a while. So I can't tell if they're still alive or not. However, after the hospital stay in the first week of November, she was put into a hospice program because they assumed that she was going to die from the cancer. So we've had a nurse coming in once a week. And so far, we have no evidence that the lung cancer has progressed. She's breathing really well. There's no sounds or strange sounds in her lungs. And her oxygen levels, the last time we checked, was 95. And that's pretty good. She's, like I say, 84. So, and she's not turning yellow, so we don't think that the cancer that was found on her liver with a PET scan or whatever they used is going anywhere. And she's not complaining of any pain within her bones or whatever. She has no broken bones or anything like that. So we think we've got that under control. And the reason that I'm telling you about the use of cannabis, or in the use of CBD, really is what I'm using to give this lady, is to show you that I've got some experience with CBD, and it seems to be helping. And we've gotten her off of, it really helps with the pain. So she's no longer taking any opioids, which she was taking a few of those, sometimes a few a day, I think. And so that has stopped. And like I say, it seems, it appears that she has no cancer in her lungs or her liver, as far as I can tell, the bone. But we have to go to a hospital and they have to check her out, a doctor, an oncologist, have to check her out and see if indeed she has any cancer. But that's not going to happen because of COVID-19. She's not leaving the house, and I don't want to leave her. I don't want her leaving the house. And I am doing everything I can to self-quarantine so that I don't get in touch with anybody who has COVID-19. The problem being that we're both so old that if we get it, and I'm a diabetic, I'm insulin dependent, I've had heart problems, I had a triple bypass 2 years ago, I'm prime target, I'm meat for death, that COVID-19 could kill me. So what's our plan? I haven't got a lot of treatment options, so far as I know, from the government or from doctors or whatever. So what we've decided to do is she's going to continue to take the 500 milligrams of CBD every day, and I'm going to start. I have a bottle of 5 grams, which will last me 10 or 12 days, and at which point I'll buy another bottle if I run out. But that's what we're going to use to treat our COVID-19. And you're saying, well, what in the world are you doing that for? Well, the endocannabinoid system in our bodies is not, it's pretty well studied at this point, but it wasn't 10 years ago. Nobody was talking about CBD, but they started using it to treat epilepsy and seizures, especially in children. And now the FDA has approved, I think they approved a drug, it's a synthetic from one of the pharmaceutical companies to treat seizures and epilepsy in people. And yes, although that's a synthetic, it's still, I think, equivalent to something like 300 milligrams of CBD plus, I think, 2 to 5 milligrams of THC that they put in there, and it seems to help, I guess. I don't know enough about that. But anyway, CBD is powerful in a human being, and it's part of a system. And part of the endocannabinoid system, that the endocannabinoid system is, what it does is try to maintain equilibrium in the body. So that if you've got some problem and it's way out of whack, the endocannabinoids will go in and try to fix that. And that pertains to both inflammation and the immune system as well. So CBD has a reputation that it can. It reduces inflammation. I think that's part of why athletes use CBD for their injuries. So it reduces inflammation, and it also will boost your immune system. And with CBD, we're looking at, when we look at what kills people, it's the inflammation and the consequences of inflammation, which is the gathering of fluid in the lungs. So you end up basically drowning. And I'm hoping that with both of us, with enough CBD, with 500 milligrams a day, that we can reduce the amount of inflammation. If COVID-19 gets into our lungs, we're hoping that we can keep the inflammation down and thereby keep the amount of fluid that's produced by the tissues in the lungs and keep that down, and it may give us half a chance at survival. That's what we're going for. We're going for trying to get through this and living through an infection of COVID-19. Like I say, we're old people, and COVID-19, it would kill us. It may kill us, but I'm going to do the best I can. I don't have a lot of options. I'm a biologist. I'm looking at the literature. I'm looking at what they're saying on what the president is saying, the different drugs that are going to be available, and I don't have a whole lot of faith. I'm hoping that CBD will help us get through an infection if we get it. And that's how it's going to happen. And although CBD is not going to kill the virus directly, it may stimulate our immune systems enough so that the immune system will kick in as well a little bit and start killing the virus on its own. You know, it's a shot in the dark. It's better than nothing. It's something. It's, you know, I don't know if it'll work. I'll keep you informed. If we get COVID-19, the two of us, and we have to go through treatments or whatever, we're going to try this. And if it works, then I'm certainly going to do another video and tell you about it. We may not get COVID-19. Not everybody gets it. But us being old and with, you know, bad immune systems as it is, we're not holding out too much hope for ourselves. So this is a last-ditch stand, if you will. And I'm making this video. I'm sure that there are thousands of people out there in the United States and elsewhere in the world who are looking at the same same predicament that I am and my friend is, and we're just going to try to get through it, and I'm sure that that's what you want to do. If we can live through it, at the other end, people seem to recover and be okay. It's like recovering from the flu. I mean, you're sick for a while, but you get back on your feet. And that's what we're hoping we can do with the CBD, is just keep it, keep the disease so that it doesn't kill us, so that we have a chance to get through this respiratory ailment without dying. And so, you know, that's all I've got. And I'm a biologist, and I feel like I should have more, that I should be able to come up with some way that's better than this, to with better odds to get us through of this viral infection, but I don't have anything. And so this is the best I've got. And to all those people out there in the same predicament as I'm in, God bless you. You know, we hope that we can get through this, and I hope you do. And if you do, if you try CBD and it seems to help, let us know, tell us in the comments, or put up a video and let us know how it worked out for you. Because, like I say, we only got a shot in the dark, and this may or may not work. I don't know. But I'm going to give it my best shot. So anyway, I'll say goodbye to you for now. And, God bless you. Good luck.